Hey, what's up everyone? Welcome to my YouTube channel, Life Science with KMD. Today I am going to explain about biotransformation. Before understanding about biotransformation, first we should know about xenobiotics. Xenobiotics is a substance foreign to the body. It includes drugs, processed food, food additives, cosmetic products, environmental pollutants and agrochemicals. Phytoalexins. Phytoalexins are dietary plant toxins. Biotransformation is needed for detoxification and protect the body from ingested toxins. So, coming to the biotransformation, definition is that chemical alteration of drugs in the body. There are like a polar, non-polar lipid soluble compound are made up of polar lipid insolubles so that they are easily excreted. Drugs which do not undergo biotransformation are streptomycin, neostigmine, which are highly polar drugs. Site of biotransformation, it is usually in the primary site is liver and other organs like kidney, intestine, lungs and plasma. Drug biotransformation. That means convert lipophilic or hydrophobic drug into a hydrophilic metabolites so that it can able to enter inside the cell. Advantage of drug biotransformation. Terminalization of drug action. That means decrease in toxicity takes place or reduced lipophilicity or decrease in renal or biliary excretion. Biliary excretion will increase and renal reabsorption will decrease. Absorbed drug has three changes, that is metabolic changes in enzyme, that is microsomal, cytoplasmic or mitochondrial, spontaneous molecular rearrangement, that is Hofmann elimination, excreted unchanged, highly polar drugs, aminoglycosides, methanotrixate, neostigmines. Consequences of drug biotransformation. Now, what are the consequences of drug biotransformation? First is drug could be inactivated, like for example morphine, paracetamol, chloramphenicol, all these could be inactivated. Next is active drug to active metabolite. Here the parent drug is converted into active metabolite. Example is digitoxin is converted into digoxin, which is an active metabolite. Inactive drug to active drug. Inactive drug could also be called as a prodrug, which can be converted into active drug. Like for example, a prodrug are inactive drug which need body temperature in the body to form an active metabolite. Then it could be more stable, better bioactivity can be seen and less toxic. Example is levodopa is converted into dopamine in the body. Types of biotransformation reaction. Usually there are two types of biotransformation reaction. One is phase 1, which is also called as non-synthetic or functionalization. Here the characteristic of phase 1 is that it is a functional group is generated in this process and usually the metabolite which is produced in this part or it could be like active or inactive form. Whereas in case of phase 2, it is also called as a synthetic or conjugation and here an endogenous radical is conjugated and the metabolite is usually in a inactive form. In case of phase 1 reaction, it is either could be oxidation, reduction, hydrolysis or cyclization or decyclization. Phase 2 reactions are glucuronide conjugation, acetylation, methylation, sulfate conjugation, glycine conjugation, glutathione conjugation, ribonucleotide or ribonucleoside synthesis. These are phase 2 reactions.
Thanks for watching my video. Please subscribe to my channel by clicking on subscription button. Subscription doesn't cost you any money. To get a notification, click on a bell icon. Do like and share this video with friends and family. If you have any kind of feedback, do share it on a comment box. Thank you.